have to utter the intention, because the intention in Arabic means niyya, from nawa, which is the seed. It is something to be concealed. It is something to be in the heart. Only Allah, the Almighty, knows about it. And this is an act of worship. You're offering dhuhr, or you're offering asr, same four rak'ahs, and both are silent. What makes this prayer dhuhr, and what makes it asr? Your hidden intention. You're praying sunnah before dhuhr, four rak'ahs. What distinguishes the sunnah from the fard? Your intention. Do you have to declare it and you tell Allah, oh Allah, I am going to pray four rak'ah sunnah or four rak'ah fard? Doesn't he already know? Okay. There is a common misconception amongst many Muslims. You hear them even in, especially in the haram, because people come from various backgrounds. They speak out loud. And it goes further. It doesn't stop at the limit of announcing the intention of praying dhuhr or asr. They say, I intend to pray dhuhr, jama'ah, in congregation, hadr, on time, in the masjid, or in the haram. That makes no sense. It's like, you know, you're talking to someone who does not know. The scholars give a very good example to refuting this common misconception and to establish the fact that an-niyyatu mahalluha al-qalb. What if you made wudu and you left your hotel like you are in the haram, and you heard the adhan for dhuhr, you came down to pray dhuhr, and before praying dhuhr, you said, oh Allah, I intend to pray asr, out of forgetfulness, a slip of your tongue. You said, pray asr instead of dhuhr. Will the prayer be valid or not? Yes, valid. How come? Because you actually intended to pray dhuhr. When you were making wudu and when you walked towards the masjid, it was to pray dhuhr, because it's dhuhr time, not asr time. So the slip of your tongue does not even count, because it is not needed. It is not required.